Now there's two backgrounds which I like to use in my watercolour paintings. One is a mottled background and the other one is a suggested detail background. So a bit blurry if you know what I mean. So I'm going to show you how to do both of those today. So let's make a start straight away. First thing we want to do is wet the background. So I've got this little bit of tape and that's around the edge of the paper. But I do like to add two or three layers of water. And every layer of water needs to kind of soak in probably for about half a minute before we put the next layer on. At least that way around, your paper will remain wetter longer, if you know what I mean. So therefore, that will give you a little bit more working time as well. And you start to find that your paper will cockle. It could bend, it could twist, it could go all over the place. I know. Okay, something like that. So that's three layers of water on there. I'm going to leave it for half a minute to soak into the paper a little bit more. If you don't, what will happen is that the paint will just float on the surface of the paper and not sink in quite as quick. And you find that if your board is on an angle like mine, they could just run down the paper like a waterfall. You don't want that to happen now, do you? Of course not. Right, that's soaked in sufficiently now. If I just lift that paper up, you can just see the cockle and the bend on the paper there, can't you? And that's where that'll want it to be. And I can see the texture of the paper as well. So I'm going to get some of my Gambo Hue. I'm going to pop this onto the paper. Look how strong that is. Oh, what a lovely colour. Just quite randomly, really. This is going to be a mottled background. Really strong mottled background. I suppose we can call this a summery one, can't we? So very summery indeed. Okay, something like that. There we go. Straight into the... Let's go for olive green, shall we, next? Why not? A little bit of olive green in there. Trying to get the drying time just right, really, when you're working with the background, because if you don't, what will happen is that if it's too dry, you get the cauliflower edges or the kind of blemishes around the paper, which you do get, obviously, because it's also a little bit too dry, and you get those very hard edges. Sometimes it can look quite nice, actually. I do like it sometimes. But other times you think, I don't like that much. Now, I'm still leaving gaps in between around here. Look how strong that bit is there. But I don't mind. We're going to vary this throughout this section as well. Now, because we've got the water on the paper, we know that that water on the paper will also dilute the colours that we add on there as well. So it could weaken those colours down. So as this dries, it will dry that little bit lighter. Depends, obviously, on how much pigment you've got within your paint. So how thick the paint is to begin with. Okay, straight into the burnt sienna. This is going to be rich, watch out. Oh no, it's not too bad. Just tickling it in here and there. Might go a bit stronger in places as well, why not? Just vary it. Now as this dries, the colours will naturally blend into one another as well. Did a little bit round there, why not? Yeah, go on lad. And maybe, just maybe, a little bit down here as well. Oh, that's rich. Okay. Now you want to let this dry naturally so it all blends together. So don't go in with the hairdryer, not at this stage anyway, just let it blend. Let it go, let it go. And once it's nice and dry, then we'll be able to see what the effect is like for a basic, straightforward, mottled background. And that's just using three colours as well. And I tend to aim for no more than four colours for a background, for a mottled one anyway. Now the thing is, once it starts to dry, then you want to leave it alone. So if you don't, as I mentioned earlier on, you start getting these cauliflower marks, these little blemishes on the paper. So I'm going to get some kitchen roll. I folded it up a little bit like that. So I've got a nice kind of sharp edge. Move that out of the way. And using your finger down the side of your block pad or board, whatever you're using, just position it like that. Okay, see what I mean? So I've got my finger there, the kitchen roll just there, and I can just very lightly come down the side of that like that, look, without touching the paint. You can see that a lot. I'm not touching the painted area. Fold it over, get a nice kind of straight edge on that again, and do the same again, and do this all the way around. Now I have noticed as well that whilst it's drying, I've got a little blemishes. Look, got one there, one there, one there. So that could either be just a drop of water, or when I'm talking, you know, things happen, don't they? Or it could be a blemish within the paper. I don't know. Now what I can do while this is still damp, I can load up my old mixing brush, and it's very old, this one, not like that, with a little bit of water. I can very lightly flick that water onto the paper. Watch this. And what this will do, it will create little tiny blemishes, which will fade as well. Okay, so it's not going to be hard edge or anything like that. Little specks. Now imagine on a summer's day, you very often see pollen or something like that floating in the sky, don't you? Quite a lot of it. So this will replicate that kind of effect as well. But can you imagine that with this mottled background, what you can then do, once it's nice and dry of course, is paint all the details over the top for grass blades or flower or something like that over the top of it. Which then, this will create a nice background effect. Now then, suggested detail. Let's have a look at that one, shall we? I'm going to do the same again by wetting the background first of all. Now this time, I'm not going to even bother washing the brush out thoroughly. So therefore, we've got a little bit of colour coming away with that brush as well. Just kind of adds to the overall effect. So I've got a little bit of a wash of colour on there straight away. I'm going to let that soak in just a fraction first of all, okay? Okay, that's soaked in a little bit now. So let's go in with some colour again. So let's go straight into the burnt sienna. We'll pop that one in. Okay. And I'm going to go into the green, so the olive green. Oh, look at that. Okay, straight into the burnt umber. I'm going to go down here first of all. That's rich. I don't think I use quite as much of this, you know. I mean, obviously, I can water my paints down a little bit more. The consistency of all these colours at the moment, by the way, are watery. And that is about it. I know. Now, I don't want this to fully dry. And the reason behind that is because I want the details I'm going to paint over the top to kind of blur and fade in a little bit as well. If I start doing that at this stage, and this is really wet at the moment, as you can see there, look. So very, very wet. Then you find the details will just blur away. It'd be too wet to do that with. So what I suggest you do, just give it probably about a minute, something like that, just to dry, and then we're going to start going in with a little bit of detail in there as well. Okay, giving it a minute to dry, what I'm going to do now is use my size 4 brush. This is a golden maple. There you go, Master Series 1 Finest Sable. Oh. I'm going to use a little bit of burnt umber first of all. And we'll try that first and see how that one fades in. Okay, you ready? Think about some twigs or anything like that coming away from this bottom corner here. A little bit of a tree, anything like that. Now it's starting to dry quite well over there and I can see the shine is just about gone off that top corner of the paper. But you can see it's still quite wet down below here, isn't it? So I know that if I go up to the top there with this brush, I'm going to get a sharp edge and I don't really want that sharp edge. So I'm going to come down here again, add some little details in there like so. So if you're drawing a tree, for example, just out of interest, what I tend to think of is think about the way that it grows. It grows from the ground upwards. So paint it from the ground upwards. Then every little branch, flick out a little line here and there as well. And let it fade into the background, like that, okay? So you're going to flick it and let it fade. Look how wet it is down here, can you see that? Because it's so wet, you find it would just fade a little bit too much, really. Depends on what kind of effect you're after, to be honest with you. So you can do all this effect just by working on damp paper like that. To create like just a suggestion of detail in the background. Okay, go straight into the green. And this is obviously that olive green. I can do the same with that one as well. Just by creating a few little details of grass blades in the background. So when this is dry, what I can then do is paint more detailed grass blades over the top. It's just a suggestion for the background. I see when you study other people's paintings, when you study landscape paintings, for example, very often you'll see blurred detail in the background. And that's basically what I'm doing here. All ready for me to add those lovely details over the top. There you go. Well, I'm going to give this one a dry now. Once it's nice and dry, then we can see what the effect is like. Now, I do paint a lot of mottled backgrounds with my wildlife paintings. And these are the videos which I record for my members on Patreon. So if you fancy painting wildlife and the occasional mottled background as well, have a look in the description down below for my Patreon link and go and take a look. And just show you what I mean there, look, I've just added a few little details here and there Just a suggestion. A suggestion of details, a suggestion of trees more than anything. As you can see here, there you go. Just by using my size 0 brush. And you can see the background suggested details showing through as well. So all that's a sort of a distant feel to it, isn't it? And that's what I'm working with here. So the same thing applies when we're working with grass. So let's get a little bit of burnt umber with that olive green. And we can use that as well to add a few little grass stems just coming up here and there. So now that I've added a few extra details over the top of this painting here, you can see the way that the suggested detail still shows through. And that gives it more of a sort of a distant feel to it, doesn't it? But it's all about getting that timing right for the wetness of the paper. Too dry, it won't blend. Too wet, it could just simply disappear and blend into everything else. So imagine this effect with a, say, mountain scene at the top of the paper. And if you use cool colours as well, that will help the painting recede. It can help it kind of sink back into that background. Okay, now if you do want to have a look at some other videos which I've got on working with watercolour backgrounds, and also watercolour effects as well, have a look at the link to the top right, okay? I'll see you there.